good.
Okay, hello everyone, and welcome to our Christmas to Believe In skit that's going to be performed by the wonderful teachers from St. Julia AME Zion Church. Let's go ahead and open up with prayer. Father God, we just thank you for this time that we can spend together and celebrate you, because truly Jesus is the reason for the season. So we thank you, Lord, for this time, oh God. Father, we pray that as we perform this skit, that it would minister to those who hear this skit. And Father, we pray that people will be blessed and encouraged, oh God. Father, I thank you, Lord, that you are Lord of all, that even though things may not be perfect at this time of the year, Father, I pray that we will remind ourselves that through you, Jesus, we have everything. So I bless these individuals for coming tonight and giving up their time, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray that you will give them a special blessing. And I pray that all will be well. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen.
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 All right. So here we are again. Okay, so we're going to start out with a scripture reference. Our scripture reference is going to be Isaiah 9:6. It's not very long, but I think it's a very powerful scripture that is related to what we're going to do today. So again, our scripture reference is Isaiah chapters 9, verse 6. Okay, is everybody ready? All right. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. So when we go over our skit that we're about to start in a little bit here, we ask that you would keep that scripture in mind and remember that we celebrate Christmas, but we also know the reason for the season, which is Jesus. Okay.
A long time ago, in the town of Bethlehem, a Savior was born, which was Christ the Lord.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. What's going on here?
What do you mean? What's going on here? What am I doing? You mean like we're doing the Christmas play? You know that. What's the matter with you? Look around you. Everyone's here. Our parents are even here. Our aunts and uncles are here. Hey, Mom!
Well, see, I've been thinking about it. And I don't know if I believe it all or not.
What? Don't believe it? Are you kidding me? What don't you believe?
I don't know if I believe in the Christmas story. Well, when I was younger, I believed in Santa Claus. And you know what happened there.
Oh man, this is worse than I thought.
Here, just take a few deep breaths. It's supposed to help.
Wait, I've had an epiphany. An epitome.
You mean epiphany?
Whatever. I'll tell you the story of Christmas and you can decide if you believe it or not. But whether you believe it or not, it's still true. And the really good thing is that since it is true, no one can ever take it away from you.
All right. If you think it will help, thanks.
Let's do it.
Bye.
A while back, There was a young woman named Mary.
Hi, Mary.
Hi. Do you believe yet?
I don't know. Wait a minute. Is she supposed to be talking to me?
Mary lived in a town called Nazareth. The town is still there. You can go see it.
Okay, thanks.
Mary was promised to be married to a man named Joseph.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful.
Quiet. One day, Mary was visited by an angel of God.
Now, see here. Wait right there. An angel here on earth talking to some girl named Mary? I mean, there is no archaeology. You know, there's no proof of that.
Did you have breakfast this morning?
Yes, cereal.
You have archaeological proof of that?
No.
My point exactly. So this angel says to Mary,
"Hail, Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee."
Does that sound like a strange greeting to you?
I imagine that's what Mary thinks. She looks really scared.
Don't be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. How would this be since I'm a virgin?
Oh, I know this one. I took it in health class.
Shh, the angel's going to tell her.
The Spirit will come upon you and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God.
Wait a minute. That's not what they told us in the health class.
I told you, the angel is still speaking.
Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a baby in her old age, for nothing is impossible with God.
It's amazing what they can do in those infertility clinics now.
Girl, this all took place over 2,000 years ago.
Sorry, my bad. What is this Elizabeth anyway? Who is she? Did you skip a page, maybe?
Wait. Mary has one more line.
I'm the Lord's servant. May it be to me as you have said.
Then the angel left her. And then Mary got ready and hurried to a town in the hill country of Judea to see her relative Elizabeth.
Hey, where is she going? Who is this Elizabeth lady?
Elizabeth was Mary's older cousin who lived in another town. She had been married to a good man named Zechariah for many, 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 did I say many years?
Strange. She doesn't look to be that old.
This is an actress. Months earlier, the angel had visited Elizabeth's husband, Zechariah.
Girl, I knew you had skipped the page.
The angel had visited Elizabeth's husband, Zechariah, when he had come to offer the sacrifice at the temple.
Wait a minute, what's the temple?
Like church, but before Jesus.
Oh.
The angel said,
"Hey, is that the same angel?"
Yes, it is. See, it was the same angel. We like to try and stay as close to reality as we can here.
Oh, yeah. I can see your angel looks just like a lot like the real thing, huh? Yeah, right.
Yeah, the angel said to Zechariah,
"Don't be afraid, Zechariah."
Your angel here seems to be saying that a lot.
Actually, angels are quite imposing figures. You can look it up in various passages in the Bible where angelic appearances are recorded. Almost all of them reflect how frightened the person seeing them became.
Girl, are you all right?
Anyway, they ended up having to say it almost every time.
Say what?
Don't be afraid.
Zechariah, your prayer has been heard. Your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you are to give him the name John. He will be a joy and delight to you, and many will rejoice because of his birth. For he will be great in the sight of the Lord, and he will help to make ready a people prepared for the Lord.
How can I be sure of this? I am old, and my wife is well along in years.
Wow. Did you hear what he just said? He called his wife old. Dude, are you in trouble?
No. Oh, he did something wrong. He did something worse than that. He questioned an angel. Watch this.
I am Gabriel. I stand in the presence of God, and I have been sent to speak to you and tell you this good news. And now you will be silent and not able to speak until the day this happens, because you did not believe my words, which will come true at the proper time.
Wait a minute. Hey, what happened to his voice?
Gone.
Longitis?
Power of God.
Wow.
You said it.
Well, it's sure that Zechariah didn't say it.
Sure enough, just like the angel had said, Zechariah and Elizabeth were soon expecting their first baby, despite their old age, but Zechariah still couldn't speak. It wasn't long ago at all before Mary came to visit her cousin Elizabeth.
Elizabeth!
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the child you will hear. As soon as the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the baby in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed is she who has believed that what the Lord has said to her will be accomplished.
My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior, for he has been mindful of the humble state of his servant. From now on, all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me. Holy is his name.
Mary's visit with Elizabeth and Zechariah lasted about 3 months, and then Mary went back home to Nazareth.
Bye, Mary.
Bye. Do you believe yet?
I don't know.
When Elizabeth's time came, she delivered a baby boy, just as the angel had told Zechariah. When it was time to name the baby, their friends and neighbors asked them,
"What is the baby's name?" "Is to be John. But none of your relatives are named John. You have to name him after someone in your family. Zechariah, what do you think about this? What is the baby's name to be?" "His name is to be John. John.
Suddenly, Zechariah could speak again.
Praise be to the Lord, the God of Israel, because he has come and has redeemed his people. And you, my child, will be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go on before the Lord to prepare the way for him, to give his people the knowledge of salvation through forgiveness of their sins because of the tender mercy of our God.
Wow. All that time in silence must have given him enough time to think about what he would say.
And John grew up and became a great man of God, just like the angel had said. And later he will be known as John the Baptist.
Wait a minute, he was a Baptist?
Let's not get into that right now. And so, that's the end of part one. Do you believe yet?
I don't know, girl. I don't know. Will Mary be back?
Oh, I'm sure she will. She has a pretty big part to fill.
All right, then. I'm hoping she'll be back.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby
back in Nazareth, we find Joseph, the man pledged to marry Mary, asleep in his bed. Joseph had had a hard day because as soon as Mary got back from visiting with Elizabeth, it was obvious to everyone that she was going to have a baby.
Oh!
Yep. Now, Joseph was a very good man, and so he wanted to be kind and generous towards Mary. But since he knew the baby wasn't his, he wasn't sure what to do next. While he was still considering his options, an angel of the Lord came to him in a dream.
Oh no, not that girl again. Didn't you have anyone else that wanted to play an angel?
Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins.
When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he had no union with her until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus.
By union, do you mean?
Yep, just like health class.
Hi, Mary.
Hi. Do you believe yet?
I don't know.
Here, you but, read but a
that
while.
Story is pretty. That's you a pretty baby a you have.
Well, because why? Because my mouth is tired. You're going to read because my mouth is tired. I've been talking all night.
Yeah, you sure have. You've said a lot. Okay, here goes. Well, let me see. Where did you leave off? Oh, here it is. Okay. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that everyone in Rome, the Rome world, were to be counted. Wait a minute. Why on earth would somebody order something that stupid?
Tax base.
Oh, now I get it. So Joseph went up from the town of Nazareth to Galilee, to Judea, to Jerusalem, to the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. Hey, is this almost over? Because I'm getting hungry. And are there going to be any cookies?
Yes. There are going to be cookies. Of course, there are going to be cookies. There are always cookies. Now read.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. And they gave birth, Mary, that is, gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in cloth and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. Hi, Mary.
Hi. Do you believe yet?
I don't know. I don't know, Mary. Where's page 12?
Yes, he's the Son of God.
And that's the end of... That's the end of part
two. Time for cookies.
No.
Come on. It's time for cookies.
No, time for songs.
Oh, how my pages get to mixed up. Yeah, I guess I took some pages off at the same time.
Yeah.
Near the little town of Bethlehem, there were some shepherds living out in the fields, watching their flocks of sheep at night.
And all of a sudden, an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and they were really scared. Don't tell me. No, not. Oh, no.
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger.
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying,
Angels, we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains.
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another,
"Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about."
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger.
Stars in the sky.
The shepherds and the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Well, that's that. What a nice Christmas story.
Hey, hold it. What happens next?
Oh, you don't want to know.
Yes, I do. What happened to Mary? What happened to the baby? How am I supposed to believe in Christmas if I don't know what happened?
Are you sure you want to know?
Yes.
Be careful. Wanting to know is the first step in believing.
All right, I want to know. Please tell me.
Well, okay. We'll read it together. You start.
No, not too fast now. Okay, ready? Not far away lived King Herod. He was king of the whole area where Mary and Joseph were living. Hey, why don't I like him?
Because you have good taste.
Oh, who are those guys coming in?
They are some wise men who lived in countries nearby. They have come to find baby Jesus.
Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him.
King Herod knew the ancient prophecies that there would be a Messiah born to the Jews. He knew that this was the king they were talking about. He secretly did not want there to be another king but himself. He called all his Jewish leaders together and asked them, "Where is the Messiah to be born?"
He will be born in Bethlehem.
King of the Jews, you say? Tell me more. Exactly when did you see this star appear?
So the wise men told King Herod exactly when they had seen the star appear.
Go and find him. And when you find him, come back here and tell me so that I can come and worship him as well.
Wait a minute. I don't like this. Herod means to hurt them.
It'll be okay.
No, it won't. We've got to do something. We've got to warn her.
There's nothing to do. Do you want to go on and hear the rest of the story?
I don't know. Well, yes, please.
Okay, then let's read. The wise men went on their way, and the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed.
On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshiped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold and of incense and myrrh.
And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
Another route? Oh, you mean they didn't go back to tell Herod? Mary is safe? Yes!
Well, not quite.
What? Well, hurry, hurry up. Keep reading. Here, let me do it. When they had gone, the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream. Oh no, you're kidding me. Not her again.
Get up. Take the child and his mother and escape to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you, for Herod is going to search for the child to kill him.
So Joseph got up, took the child and his mother during the night and left for Egypt, where they stayed until the death of Herod.
Yes, they made it. She's safe, the baby is safe. Even Joseph is safe. That is the greatest story ever. That is the coolest angel I have ever seen. Angel, nice, good job. So is that the end?
Well, almost, almost. Later, Joseph was visited by an angel in a dream and told that Herod had died. So he and Mary and the young child Jesus moved back from Egypt to their hometown of Nazareth. And there is a very happy ending. Jesus grew up, lived a sinless life, taught about God who was his father, and later paid the price for the sins of the world. And now all of those who believe in him will have eternal life. So now the question is the same one Mary has been asking you all night long.
Do you believe yet?
Do I believe yet? Well, yes, yes. You know, I think I do. I really do.
You see, it really is a Christmas to believe in.
That was awesome. Time for punch and cookies now?
Right after this last song.
I do believe, you know, I think it was that angel. She was great.
I believe forgiveness.
Okay, Mr. Wilson, do you have the Jeopardy game?
I do. Just give me a second. I have to share my screen. Okay. Yeah. Gotta use some breath.
And everybody can play the Jeopardy game, I'm hoping, so.